Hey, it's Katie, and welcome back to my BookTube channel. You've probably noticed that we are in a different location than usual, and that's because this video, I will kind of film different chunks of it throughout the course of about a week, because for this video, I'm trying to figure out the best book boyfriend. So I created a bracket earlier this week, and I wrote out all of the book boyfriends I could think of from the books that I've read. And then I went on my Instagram, Book Adventures with Katie, and I put up polls on my story so that my followers could help me decide who the true best book boyfriend is. And so I did like a different round every day over the course of the week. So I will be in different outfits and the lighting might look a little bit different, but I will be coming on every night after the results are in for the polls and updating you guys and updating my bracket. So yeah, I will also pop up the screenshots that I took of the poll results so you guys can see those too and see if it's a landslide or if it was close, those kinds of things. But hopefully you guys like this video. I've had a lot of fun with it and I've gotten to connect with a lot of my followers on Instagram, so that's been really fun for me too. But let's jump into round one. Okay, so the first poll for round one was Peeta versus Gale from The Hunger Games. And I personally feel like Peeta is the better book boyfriend. So I was really hoping that you guys agreed, and you did, because 73% of you also chose Peeta, which I was very excited about. So he moved on to the next round. Our next poll was Will versus Jem from The Infernal Devices by Cassandra Clare. And I thought this one would be a lot closer, honestly, because personally, I had a tough time choosing which one I wanted Tessa to be with while I was reading the series. I definitely had a favorite at the end, but it was a really tough choice, so I thought it would be a lot closer. But personally, I would have voted for Will because I love how sassy he is and how snarky he is and how much he developed as a person throughout the series. And you guys agreed, 78% of you picked Will versus 22% for Jem, which I was very surprised. It was kind of a landslide. Next, we had Prince Cardin from The Cruel Prince by Holly Black versus Roma Montagov from These Violent Delights by Chloe Gong, which is a newer book, so I wasn't really sure if you guys would have read that compared to The Cruel Prince, which has been around for a while, but I just recently read it. I really enjoyed the book, and I thought he was a pretty strong contender for a book boyfriend, so I just put him in there anyway, but I personally wasn't really sure who I would have picked for this because I didn't really like Cardin in The Cruel Prince. I've only read the first book in the series, so he probably gets so much better. He already developed so much in the first book. But because of how mean he was to Jude at the beginning, it was kind of hard for me to, you know, consider him a book boyfriend. And Roma, I didn't really connect with either. He didn't do anything too bad like that, but I didn't really connect to either of these characters. But I probably would have picked Prince Cardin in the end, just because he developed a lot, and toward the end I really did start to enjoy him as a character, so that's probably who I would have picked. And the results for this one are 84% for Cardin and only 16% for Roma. This next one I was very curious to see because it is very close to my heart. It is between Julian and Dante from Caraval, and I love both of these characters. I love the whole series, and I probably would have been slightly leaning toward Julian, but whatever you guys picked, I would have been happy with. And 63% of you chose Julian, so he will be moving on to the next round. Up next, we had Gainsey from The Raven Cycle by Maggie Stiefvater versus Marco from The Night Circus by Aaron Morgenstern. And personally, I think I was leaning a little bit toward Marco only because this was a weird one for me. I wasn't really too sure who I wanted to win because I didn't really have too much of a connection to either. I've only read one book from The Raven Cycle, so I didn't feel too connected to Gainsey. And then The Night Circus, I did enjoy, but it took me so long to read that I also wasn't too connected to Marco. I just did think he seemed super sweet, and so I was leaning toward him. But The results were 38% for Gainsey and 62% for Marco. For this next one, my followers did not help me decide who should move on because it was split exactly 50-50. It was between Elias from An Ember in the Ashes and Prince Kai from Cinder. And the only thing I could think to do was to flip a coin at the end because, like I said, it was exactly 50-50. And this was one that I, again, didn't really, there wasn't one strong contender over another for me, so I felt like it was only fair to flip a coin. And so I ended up deciding heads would be for Elias and tails would be for Prince Kai, and it was heads, so Elias will be moving on to the next round. Up next, we had two characters from Children of Blood and Bone by Tomi Adeyemi, and it was Enan versus Rowan. And personally, I was really hoping Rowan would win. I love him so much. He's the one I ship Saley with 100%. He is just so badass and so snarky, I guess. I don't know. But then he also has like such a sweet, soft side around Saley, and he's one of my favorite characters from that series. So I was really hoping that he would pull through, but it ended up being 55% for Enan and only 45% for Rowan, so Enan is moving on. The next poll that I put up were two characters that weren't from fantasies, which I honestly didn't have as many of as I was expecting, but it was Porter from Alex Approximately by Jen Bennett versus Wes from 10 Blind Dates by Ashley Elston, which I just read recently, and it honestly, again, was a tough choice for me, which is the whole reason I reached out to my followers, was because I could not decide these on my own. But I think I probably would have picked Wes, only because for the most part he seemed a lot sweeter and he was very protective, and I really enjoyed that. And Porter, on the other hand, was very, not mean, but you know, like the badass character. Like, he wasn't too nice at the beginning, and then obviously he developed a lot throughout the book. But I was kind of leaning toward Wes personally, but you guys decided, 67% of you decided that Porter should move on, so you will see him in the next round. Next, we're moving on to the Mortal Instruments series, where we had Jace versus Simon. And personally, I've always been team Jace, so I was hoping that he would pull through, and 81% of you agreed, so that's exciting for me. This is one I really wanted one to win over the other, so I'm glad it worked out. And then next, this one's a throwback. I honestly kind of forgot about Twilight till like we were halfway through this, but we had Edward versus Jacob, and I was always team Jacob. I'm not sure why, but maybe because personally I thought Taylor Lautner was a lot cuter than Robert Pattinson, so that's probably why. But I was always team Jacob growing up, and so that's who I would have picked. But 67% of you chose Edward, which I was kind of expecting. I feel like a lot of people prefer him over Jacob. This next poll was one that I was watching very closely because it was between Wrath from Kingdom of the Wicked and Reed from Serpent and Dove. And if you watched my Kingdom of the Wicked review, you know that I am obsessed with Wrath. I'm obsessed with that book. It's consumed my thoughts since the moment I picked it up. And so I was really hoping that he would win, and thankfully he did. It was 68% to 32% for Reed. This next set of characters were from the first book I read this year, and that is Legendborn by Tracy Dion. So we had Cell versus Nick, and I was really hoping Cell would win. He was honestly super crappy toward the beginning of the book. He was so mean to Bree, but he changed so much throughout the course of the story, and you see so many different sides of him toward the end, and so I really connected to him. And with Nick, he was very sweet from the beginning, and he was very dynamic too, but I think I just never really shipped him with Bree, so I was really hoping Cell would win. And 56% of you chose Cell versus 44% for Nick, so that one was really close. This next pairing was actually suggested to me by one of my followers, so thank you for that. And it is Maxon versus Aspen from the Selection series, and I've only read book one, so take my opinion with a grain of salt because of that, but I was team Maxon. I definitely liked Aspen toward the very beginning, but very quickly, I decided that I was not Team Aspen. I definitely wanted America to be with Maxon. So I was really hoping that you guys agreed, and thankfully 86% of you did. Our next one is another book that I read this year, and that is From Shadow and Bone by Leigh Bardugo. I finally jumped into this series. I've only read the first book still, but we're getting there. And it was between Mal and the Darkling. And this was a tough choice for me because I didn't really get romantic vibes from Mal. I really liked him as a friend for Alina, but I really didn't want them to be together romantically. And then with the Darkling, I have a love-hate relationship with him. I'm not sure what happens in the rest of the series, but so far I went back and forth with whether or not I liked him, but I saw a lot more like passion with that. So I would have chosen the Darkling, and 62% of you agreed. Up next, we have Two Guys from Red Queen by Victoria Aveyard, and that is Maven and Cal. And this one, I honestly wasn't too sure because at the beginning, I really liked Cal, and then I was really Team Maven, and then I was Team Cal again. So I think I just have a really hard time making up my mind in a lot of these books, but I would have chosen Cal at the end because I always kind of had a soft spot for him. And even when I didn't agree with some of the choices he was making, I still had faith in him as a person. So I probably would have chosen Cal. And this one was really close. It was 44% for Maven and 56% for Cal. And last but not least, we had Miles from Prince Charming by Rachel Hawkins versus Jack from Tweet Cute by Emma Lord. And this was one of the other pairings I had that were not from fantasies, so I was very curious to see how many people had read these books and what you guys thought. I loved both of these guys, but I was kind of leaning toward Miles just because he still had like a little bit of that bad boy in him, but for the most part he was a very sweet guy, very protective, and very caring, so I picked him. And Jack's super funny, so I can see why 64% of you chose him over Miles. That is the end of round one. Please comment below who your favorite book boyfriend is and if you would have chosen differently for any of these polls. I would love to see what you guys think. And now let's move on to round two. All right. Hey guys, welcome back to round two. This round, we were down to, I think, 16 guys, so there were 8 polls that I put up on my Instagram story, and I'm just gonna, you know, keep going through the bracket and tell you guys who I wanted to win and who actually won. So, the first matchup was between PETA and Will, and this one was tough because I feel like both of them were very strong contenders, but I think I would probably lean toward Will because I tend to like the guys that are a little sassier and still have a sweet side, so that would be Will in this case. And Will ended up winning with 55%, so it was a pretty close poll. Alright, the second poll, we had Cardin from The Cruel Prince versus Julian from Caraval, and if you've watched any of my previous videos, you know I love Caraval, so Julian has my heart between these two. I've also only read the first book in the Cruel Prince series, so that could also be why. But Cardin actually ended up winning with 66% of the votes. Up next, we had Marco from Night Circus versus Elias from An Ember in the Ashes. And personally, I would have chosen Elias just because I connected with him a little bit more. And with the Night Circus in general, I didn't really connect to the characters too much. So I just feel like that book was a little wordier than what I'm used to. So I didn't really get to connect to them as much. So I would have picked Elias, and you guys agreed. It was 61% for Elias and only 39% for Marco. Then we had Enon from Children of Blood and Bone versus Porter from Alex Approximately by Jen Bennett. And I personally would have chosen Porter because, as I've mentioned before, I didn't really like Enon as a character. I preferred Ronan as the love interest in that series, so I kind of like pushed away anything good about Enon once I chose Rowan. So I would have chosen Porter because I liked him from that book. I don't even know if that was English, but Anyway, my choice would have been Porter, but you guys decided to pick Enan. It was 65% for Enan versus 35% for Porter. So Enan will be moving on. All right, on to the other side of the bracket for round two. We had Jace from Mortal Instruments versus Edward from Twilight. And I am personally a Jace fan. Again, I like the guys that are a little sassier and snarkier and you have good banter with, so I would have preferred Jace, and he had 60% of the votes versus Edward with only 40%. Our next poll was between Wrath from Kingdom of the Wicked and Cell from Legendborn, and I am obsessed with Wrath. I've probably mentioned it in this video. I've mentioned it a lot lately, so he obviously would be my pick. And I was very surprised, but also very excited that 71% of you agreed, and Wrath will be moving on to the next round. After that, we had Maxon from the Selection series versus the Darkling from Shadow and Bone, and this was by far the closest poll from round two. There was only a 1 point difference, or 1 vote difference, I think, and Maxon ended up winning 51% to 49%, which is crazy. That was super close. And our last poll for round two was between Cal from Red Queen and Jack from Tweet Cute. And personally, I would probably pick Cal just because I tend to lean toward the love interest from fantasy series over those from romance or contemporaries or anything like that. So I probably would pick Cal, and this was a landslide. Cal ended up getting 87% of the votes, with Jack only getting 13. So we will see Cal in the next round. All right, so I don't know if you can see it, but this is what our bracket currently looks like at the end of round two. So I will be back tomorrow night to tell you guys who are our final four. Hey guys, welcome to round three. Sorry if I kind of look like a mess. I just got off work, but I was really excited to see the results. So this is what our bracket looks like before we see the results of round three. Our first poll was between Will from The Infernal Devices and Cardin from The Cruel Prince. And I have a soft spot for Will. I have ever since reading the series last year. And so he would be my pick. And 53% of you agreed. So Will is moving on to the next round. Our next poll was between Elias and Enan, and you guys know how I feel about Enan, so obviously I was rooting for Elias to win, and he surprisingly won by a landslide, 86% to 14%. The next poll was between Jace from the Mortal Instruments and Wrath from Kingdom of the Wicked, and I love Wrath, I'm sure you know. And I also really like Jace, so whichever one won, I would have been very happy with, but I was definitely rooting for Wrath personally, and I thought Jace would win by a lot just because that series was more popular and Kingdom of the Wicked came out just at the end of last year, but I was surprised by how close it really was, and Wrath actually ended up winning with 55% to Jace's 45%. And then our last poll of round three, and definitely our closest, was between Maxon from the Selection series and Cal from Red Queen. And I feel about the same about both of these characters. I enjoyed them both, but I've only read the first book in both of these series, so I didn't really connect to either of them too much. I probably would have leaned toward Cal a little bit, but overall, I felt pretty neutral about this one. And it was 51% for Maxon and 49% for Cal, so Maxon will be moving on to the next round. All right, so here is our final four for the best book boyfriends. We have Will from The Infernal Devices, Elias from An Ember in the Ashes, Wrath from Kingdom of the Wicked, and Maxon from the Selection series. So I will see you guys in round four. Welcome to round four. These results were actually ready last night during the Super Bowl, but I chose to watch the game instead of film them, so I already know who ended up winning those last polls because I needed to put up the poll to decide our best book boyfriend, so I already kind of know who won, but I will tell you guys, and we were down to our final four. We had Will versus Elias and Wrath versus Maxon. So for Will versus Elias, I personally wanted Will to win because, Like I've said, I feel very connected to him since reading The Infernal Devices, and I've only read the first book in An Ember in the Ashes, so I'm not as connected to Elias. And you guys agreed, 71% of you decided that Will should move on to the championship. And then for the poll between Wrath and Maxon, obviously I was hoping Wrath would pull through. He's one of my favorites. I feel like I've said it a billion times, but it's still true. And this one was honestly very close. 54% of the votes went to Wrath and 46 went to Maxon. So this one was a nail biter. So this is what our bracket looks like at the end of round four. Hopefully you guys can read it. In our championship, we will have Will versus Wrath, and I'll be back really soon to see you guys in round five with the results. All right, guys, welcome to round five, which is the championship round. We have Will from The Infernal Devices versus Wrath from Kingdom of the Wicked, and I love both of these characters so much. I'm honestly very surprised that Wrath made it all the way to the championship round, but I know that The Infernal Devices is a very well-loved series, so it's no surprise to me that Will has made it, and I'm very curious to see who has won because both of these guys are amazing. I personally can't choose between the two, so let's see what you guys voted. All right, so it looks like Will is our best book boyfriend. He had 65% of the votes, with Wrath only having 35%. So let's write Will in the winning spot. But here is our official book boyfriend bracket. If you participated on my Bookstagram, I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. If you want to participate in things like this in the future, go ahead and find me at Book Adventures with Katie. I think I have it linked in the description, so you can just click that link and go ahead and follow me. I would really appreciate it. But thank you guys for, I don't know, I had a lot of fun with this. So I'm glad that there were a lot of people interested in voting for these things. If you have other video ideas like this, or if you want to see more bracket videos, because I thought about doing, as I read, like, I think there's 32 slots on here. So as I read the first 32 books of the year, doing a bracket for that to see what my favorite book of the year has been so far, and like doing that in chunks. So if you'd be interested in that, let me know. But please like this video, comment who your favorite book boyfriend was, and also if you'd like to see more videos like this, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so you know when I upload next. Thank you guys so much for watching. I can't wait to see you in my next video.